Hey guys, so I wanted to give an update. We're up here on the front porch. I'm gonna try my best to look here and not here anyway. So up here on the front porch, here are, can you see that? The two whiskey barrel planters had the tulips in them this spring. They were gorgeous. They came up really, really well. They've all died back now. And so I'm gonna dig them up and we're gonna plant them out in the landscape. I don't know where yet, but that's what we're gonna do. So I'm gonna dig those up. I also wanna show you a little bit. I'm gonna show you a little more update on the other pots that I planted throughout the spring that I've shown you on and off. So let me flip the camera around and we'll go. Okay, so here are those whiskey barrels. Here's this one. This one still has two, I mean, they're pretty good other than a little bug damage, but I'm gonna go ahead and dig them all out and get them planted up. And let me show you what I'm gonna plant in them. So I went to Walmart today. Ooh, and I got a fern. I'm gonna have Caleb put me a, see how these have these things sticking out? And I have a strawberry plant here and then our hummingbird feeder here. I'm gonna have him put me those rack things on both of these poles as well. And I'm gonna hang the fern at some point. Somewhere, maybe here, down here on the end, because they like a little shade, little sun. So I think hanging up here is gonna be great. Here are those. This is not a purple fountain grass. This is a, I can't remember. I'll have to go back and look. Anyway, a grass, an ornamental grass. And these other planters. Oh my gosh, my mind is going blank. Maybe I left the tags. This is a coxcomb. Yeah, dark purple coxcomb. Look how pretty. It's done so well. We've had so much rain. And it's just, it's kind of holding its own. And then here's an up close of the other grass. So we have all four of those. I have trash that needs picked up. I'm going to cut back these. There are tulips and daffodils here on either side with the lights. I'm gonna cut those back today. Here are the planters that I did. This is the Proven Winners Bubblegum Supertunias, along with the green fountain grass, or not fountain grass, sorry, the green sweet potato vine. I can't talk today. I shouldn't be doing a video. There's one in the shade. You can maybe see it better. So there's the sweet potato vine. And I don't even know what this thing is called, but it looks really cool. So, okay. So for the whiskey barrels. So I've got these little lollipop topiary boxwoods. I think they're boxwoods. Yeah. Anyway, they're cute. And then coleus and hibiscus. I think these all three are gonna look really good in these containers. So I'll get those planted up and show you. And look at the strawberries. This one's about ready. We picked two last night, but it's just loaded with little strawberry plants. Oh, there's another one about to turn. So cute, I love it. So that's my chores for today. I got an edging tool Caleb bought me, and it was part of my Mother's Day stuff when I got these plants and then the edging tool. So what I'm gonna do, because these keep falling over, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the edging tool and go through and basically chop out the grass with the edging tool and have those bricks sit a little better down in there. Check this tomato plant out. Can you see that? It's so sunny. It was like this big when we planted it in here. And I've got some beans coming up in that little pot. So Anyway, this is the front porch little tour. It's not looking very good right now because of all of this. It's been so rainy that I haven't gotten out here to clean any of it out. These, let me dig this out. I had to put them back here behind this thing because we had a storm the other night. And they were blowing these things all over. These are called, let me show you the tag. Yeah, look at these little trumpet flowers. Aren't those gorgeous? I love that. These are actually more of like a bush. So I think that I'm gonna put them out here along this fence. Where the lilies and the rose bush and things like that are. I think that's where I'm going to put them. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, I will give you a garden tour at some point. It's really weedy, and so I'm going to have to go through and do some maintenance on it before I can do anything. So, anyway, hang with me. I'm going to clean these out, and I'll come back, and I will show you as I'm planting all of this pretty stuff. Okay guys, I went and got my little, we call this the Forrest Gump mower because it's a little snapper like the one he drove in the movie. This snapper has been at the Langham Farm for many, many years. It's still going strong. We love it. We've got a gorilla cart and Caleb rigged it up for me on a sort of little hitch system so that way I can get on, he calls it my buggy, we get on my little buggy and I can haul my things all around the farm while I'm working. So, but I wanted to show you guys. I parked over here on the, here's the front porch. I moved the barrels over here. That way they're taller. I can stand on the ground and I can work a little easier. So hopefully that'll be better. But I wanted to show you, Caleb, see my weed eater? Isn't it cute? It's battery powered, it's a Ryobi. We went just looking for the weed eater, but it came with a blower as well. It came with a 40 volt, I think, 18 volt, but it's 40 something. Anyway, 48. Anyway, 18 volt battery. It runs both of them, and apparently this battery will run pretty much anything that they do, any Ryobi things that they make. But if you don't know, Caleb has three herniated discs in his lower back. So for him, bending at the waist, just, it doesn't work for him. It pinches all those nerves. He just can't physically do it right now. We have surgery at some point this summer, hopefully, fingers crossed. With all the virus stuff going on, it's taking time to get in. But anyway, so he got me this very light. I think it only weighs 4 pounds, I think is what the box said. And it's only a 10 inch weed eater, but it fits me perfectly. I'm only 5'1", so I can easily lift. It's super light plastic. I can easily weed eat around the porches and my flower beds and things like that around the little trees. As you can see, that one needs it, so I'm gonna do that today as well. But I can get back here and I can weed eat where I need to. Any heavy duty weeding is just gonna have to wait until after he's fixed and healed up. So anyway, I wanted to show you guys that. Obviously not sponsored, but you know, that would be nice. Anyway. Okay, I got these two. These are plastic, guys. I got those at these at Tractor Supply, I don't know, 3 years ago now, two, 3 years ago. Anyway, I got them all cleaned out. There's all the tulips I dug out. I am sure that I've missed some. I don't remove all of my soil every single year. I just don't. I add more nutrients to the soil, and that's what we do. So it's too expensive to keep redoing it. See my mess? Yeah, that's because in this pot, which was over here, I swapped them to work on them. Yeah, there's a giant lizard living in that pot, and it scared the daylights out of me. So yeah. I think he is somewhere in that flower bed now, but he was not happy to be woken up. So, yeah. Anyway, scared me to death. Anyway, there's all my tulips, and
And yeah, I'm going to fertilize and start planting. I will show you the, you know, the finished product. Okay. These, I kind of turned them a little backwards for the blooms that are on them now, but they'll bloom out. And there it is on the other side. I think it's going to be really pretty. That coleus will flush out big. I don't know about the hibiscus. Hopefully it will. It's kind of muggy here in Arkansas, but it should do okay. I'll post updates at some point. So this is the side of the porch, front porch, this is where we park Atkins. So I think these two bougainvilleas, I think I'm going to plant on either side of these steps so that it fills in here. Most people don't use this side, so it's just kind of just a convenient step off the porch for us. So I think they'll be really pretty over here. They get partial sun and shade, so I think they'll do really well. So I'm going to plant those up and then I'll show you what it looks like afterwards. Okay guys, I got the, what did I call these? These little yellow ones, bougainvillea, something like that. Anyway, they're planted here on either side of the porch steps, the side porch steps. I got the tulip bulbs planted. There's a rose bush right there, and I got them planted right beside that. Hopefully they'll come up this spring. I'm going to show you tomatoes. This is a cherry tomato plant. And where'd they go? There's little babies. Can you see the babies? Yeah. So excited. Sorry. I'm using my phone, so it's not great. Anyway, I moved these pots right here down off the porch. They get more sunshine here, and super tunias want sunshine. So, and so do potato vines. So they'll get more sun down here. You see on the porch, it's shaded. They want sun. So put those there. And there are the other, the whiskey barrel pots. There's my reflection. But got those on either side of the door. And for the most part, I got the pew cleaned off. I'm gonna get a bucket and some soap and water and wipe this all down. I kept out the plant food with the our watering cans because that way I can keep it up here and remember to fertilize. And then hummingbird water, which there's our feeder. So. Caleb went, he got the wrong hydraulic fluid for the tractor, so he went to get traded out, get the right kind. So he's gone. It's hay season. I think he's gonna start cutting today. I think he's gonna cut this front field right here. Look how tall that grass is. I'm so excited. He's supposed to be doing video. So hopefully he's documenting all the work that he's doing to cut this hay, make the farm pretty, get this great grass cut. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed today seeing all the pots come together and these front ones. I love sharing the flowers with you. I know it's not super farm-ish, but it is what we're doing. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. Subscribe, like, share with your friends. We need more subscribers. Thank you. Bye.